Note: the following video depicts a specific configuration of the notebook. The same removal and replacement procedures apply to all configurations of the notebook. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, wireless module, and wireless WAN module if installed. Removal. Important: make careful note of the routing of all cables for later replacement. Remove the wireless antenna cables from the routing channel on the top cover. Remove the 5mm P1 Phillips-head screw that secures the right display panel hinge to the top cover. Carefully open the right display panel hinge. Remove the right display panel hinge support bracket from the alignment pin on the top cover and system board, and remove. Disconnect the power connector cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard ribbon cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Peel back the retention tape and disconnect the touchscreen cable from its connector on the system board. Disconnect the display panel cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the power button board ZIF connector and disconnect the power button board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Remove the two 3mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the heatsink to the top cover. Remove the four 3mm P1 Phillips head screws identified with triangles that secure the system board to the top cover. Lift the system board off of the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Replacement. Note: before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install on the new system board. Heatsink. Place the system board onto the alignment pins on the top cover. Caution: ensure that all cables are free from being pinched between the top cover and system board. Replace the four 3mm P1 Phillips head screws identified with triangles that secure the system board to the top cover. Replace the two 3mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the heatsink to the top cover. Insert the touchpad board ribbon cable into the touchpad board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the power button board ribbon cable into the power button board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Connect the display panel cable onto its connector on the system board. Connect the touchscreen cable into its connector on the system board and replace the retention tape. Insert the keyboard ribbon cable into the keyboard ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Connect the power connector cable into its connector on the system board. Route the power connector cable through the routing channel on the top cover. Place the right display panel hinge support bracket onto the alignment pin on the top cover and system board. Close the right display panel hinge. Replace the 5mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the right display panel hinge to the top cover. Route the wireless antenna cables through the routing channel on the top cover. Important! After system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings, injecting Microsoft Windows 8 digital product keys.